Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Danielle, and if you haven't already subscribed, make sure to subscribe and also follow me on all of my social medias. I always have them linked down below. For today's video, I'm just going to be sitting in my car doing a little chit chat video for you guys. I feel like I haven't done like a sit down video in such a long time, and I love doing them in my car. I don't know why, I just feel like so much more comfortable. I don't even have shoes on right now. I walked outside with just my socks and I'm sitting crisscross applesauce in my car right now, but I wanted to do this video for you guys talking about my 1 month school update at cosmetology school. So if you don't already know, I am a student at Toni&Guy Hairdressing Academy. That is obviously a cosmetology school. And today actually marks 1 month of being in school. I started February 3rd. So it is March 3rd today, and it's still just crazy to me that I've already been there for a month. I feel like I just started last week, but I wanted to do this video for anyone who is either debating on going to cosmetology school or already signed up and is starting in a few months, because I know when I first started, or even before I started, I binged watched these videos all over YouTube. I watched Days in My Life. I watched What Cosmetology School Is Like videos, What to Expect videos, like I watched it all. So now that I have been experiencing it myself, I thought I would also post one of these videos to help anyone who needs it. So yeah, let's get started. Okay, so I first kind of just wanted to start off by talking about like my background information and stuff. So cosmetology school actually wasn't my first choice, I guess you could say. I actually was going to Rhode Island College for medical imaging, which is like x-rays, ultrasounds, stuff like that. And I went to RIC for a year and a half, and I honestly just knew that something wasn't right. Something didn't really click, and I really just didn't want to be in the medical field. It wasn't for me. So that's when I later decided that I really wanted to do cosmetology school. I honestly wanted to do cosmetology school for a very long time, but unfortunately I just didn't really speak up or say anything because I felt like I would get judged, or I felt like I wouldn't really be accepted for doing it. But honestly, I'm so glad that I stopped listening to myself and just did it, because I have never been so happy in my entire life. Being in college and doing all of that work as far as medical classes and stuff like that, oh my god, I was so stressed. I cried way too much. And now being in this type of scenery in school, I have so much to be thankful for. I love it. I always go in with a smile on my face. I love doing it. It just makes me happy. So if you're in the same boat and you're scared to go into cosmetology school because of what other people might think, just ignore it and do it if it's going to make you happy. And I just wanted to start off by saying that, because I feel like it's so important, and if I didn't stop listening to myself, I would probably still be at RIC crying every single day. All right, so now that I got that off my chest for you guys to hear, I also wanted to briefly talk about all the different kinds of opportunities that you can do from this, because before I even started this school, I thought it was just hair, like that was it. But I have learned so much more than just that, and I've learned like all the different things you can do. You can do hair, obviously, makeup, eyelash extensions, hair extensions, you can do nails, you can specialize in keratin treatments. Like, there is so many different opportunities. So if you think you're like not that much into hair. You can just stick with makeup, eyelashes, stuff like that. Or if you were just into hair, you can just do that. But yeah, I also think that's kind of something that people really need to know and learn, is that it's not just hair that you can learn. Like, you learn a variety of things. And Toni and Guy actually has a few classes as far as lashes goes, waxing goes, and we do keratin classes too to get certified. So if you're looking into that, then definitely check out Toni and Guy. And personally, just for me, I would love to stick with just hair and hopefully in the future own my own salon. That's like my number one goal. So yeah, now getting into everything that I did this month in school. I really truly didn't know that we were going to be learning this much in such a short amount of time. This program is only a 9-month program, so I'll actually be graduating in October of 2020, which is mind-boggling. Like, what? I won't even be 21 yet and I'll have like an actual full-time job. It's nuts to me. But I can't wait for October. Oh my god. But anyways, so yeah, it is such a fast-paced program, but I love that about it because each day you're learning something new. So it's not like every week you're just dragging on the same skill. Like, every single day is a different hair technique. You're either learning a cut one day, you're learning highlights another day, balayage the next, another cut. Like, it goes by fast. But the way Toni and Guy spaces everything out is perfect because you really feel like you're learning how to do it, and it's not just like, I'm just doing my best. Like, I have no idea what I'm doing, but I just gotta do it. Like, I never feel like that. But basically, a day-to-day schedule for us is we'll get there at 9, but this is also depending on the program that you sign up for. So I am a full-time student, which is Tuesday through Saturday, 9 to 4:30. But there's also like the nighttime program, half day, part-time. Like, there's a ton of different options you can choose from, but I just wanted to do the full-time program just to get it done as fast as I can. So a typical day for me would be clocking in at 9 o'clock, and then we have this thing called theory, which is basically where we take notes and do book work. And this is another thing I really wanted to talk about because I feel like people don't really get that it is still hard work at cosmetology school. Like, it's not some easy, like, oh, that's cosmetology, oh, it's so easy, like, whatever. No, we have to do bookwork, notes, we have to study, we take tests, we take quizzes, we have homework. Like, it's just the same amount of work. So for theory, the first one we did was, I'm pretty sure, color theory. And how the book works is there will be like a sentence with blanks, and the teacher will just read each sentence and fill in the blank on like a slideshow. So that's how we do the notes. And then after theory, there's always like a break. You get like a 10 to 15 minute break, and then we go straight into whatever we're doing. So let's just say the first thing you do is a one length cut. It's just you cut the hair straight across, and that's that. We would watch the video on how to do it, and then we would go and wash, shampoo, and condition our mannequin, and then we would come back to the room and my teacher would do a demo on how to do it, and then we would just do it. So there's two different sources of step-by-step ways of how to do the haircut, and then it's our turn to do it, which I really like. It's not just, oh, here's the video, all right, do it. Like, the teacher goes step by step and shows you on his own mannequin and does it. So I really loved how he did that. And then we obviously have a 30-minute lunch break. We'll come back from lunch. If we didn't finish, we'll finish. Usually after lunch, for a one-length cut, we would like blow dry her hair out and style it, and then we'll take another break, and depending on how much we have left or if we're done, we'll just find something else to do. Like, we'll practice prom updos, braids, and stuff like that. But if it's a day where we're doing color, usually it lasts the whole day and we have to use our time wisely. But usually haircuts are the fastest, and then we'll just find something else to do like the last hour and a half. But it is a very fast-paced cycle, and I honestly love that about it. It just is perfect because I feel like I've only been there for a month, but I already know so much. Like, within the month, I've learned how to shampoo and condition and massage the scalp correctly. I've learned a one-length cut, round layers, square layers, inversion layers. We did a pixie cut. We did men's cuts, and then we also did highlights, a balayage. We've done global lightener, which is you lighten the entire head with bleach, and then you'll go in with whatever color you want. I did purple, and then you just use the purple over the bleached hair. So we did that. We've also done like a full head of highlights, not just like little tiny highlights. We did a full head of highlights. That was nuts. But we've already done so much, and it's crazy how much I've learned. A month ago, I didn't even know how to braid. Like, yeah, I can do the normal braid, whatever, but I did not know how to French braid or Dutch braid, and now I can do it like that. And a balayage, like, what? It's just crazy to me how much I've learned. But because it's such a fast-paced program, like, you have to know how to do each of these things, because after 2 months, you're already on the floor taking clients, so you have to know. So I feel like the first 2 months are the most important months of this program, because you're in the classroom learning all the fundamentals, and then you're on the floor taking clients who expect you to know. So that's why it's such fast pace, but I love it. And another thing that I also really love is that every other Saturday we can take clients in the classroom, which is amazing because it really sets you up for when you go to the floor and take clients. They let you take clients every other Saturday in the classroom so that you could truly experience what it's like to work on humans before you get on the floor. So I really like how they did that. I actually did one this Saturday, and it was just a simple prom updo because my boyfriend's cousin wants me to do her hair for prom, and she just wanted to do like a trial run to see how it would come out, and it came out so cute. If you want to go check it out, you can follow my beauty page. I have it linked down below. And yeah, so that's another cool thing that they let us do. And I know you guys probably don't want me to talk about it, you don't want to hear it, but about tests and quizzes, I'm just gonna talk about it briefly, okay? Because you really need to know. It's very important. So there's a few things that get graded. The first thing is your lesson challenges, which I feel like every teacher does it differently, but our teacher does it after every single theory, and we all do it together, so no matter what, we all get 100s because we'll go through theory, fill out the notes, and then after each theory there's a lesson challenge, and it's just like multiple choice. It's on our iPad, and we just go around the class, read the question, answer it, and if it's wrong, the teacher will be like, no, and then we'll get the right answer. So that's one of the things. And for the first month, I only took 2 of the tests. So how those work is, first there's a pre-test, which you still get graded on, but it's not as high of a percent as the actual test. So the pre-test is just to like get you ready for the test, and then the test is based off of the questions from the pre-test, but they're just all in a different order. It's the same exact questions, just different order. And like I said, for the first month we only had 2. The first one was all about color, and then the second one was all about like hair care, diseases in the hair, conditions of the hair, massages, shampooing, like just hair care. And I passed both of those. They were pretty good. And another thing too that our teacher allows us is extra credit. So the ways we can do that is by making flashcards, we can do, like, we get an exam prep book. Everyone should get one. And it's multiple choice questions. And as long as you fill out the chapter that we're doing the test on, you just show them, and that's extra credit as well. So there's several different things on how to get a good grade. And then lastly, I just wanted to talk about how our school does a ton of like shows and trips, which is really nice. Actually, tomorrow I'm doing a catwalk and I'm the model. Because since I'm still in the classroom, I don't really have that much experience to do a model's like hair, makeup, all of that stuff. But I really liked how all of the girls came in and asked if any of us wanted to be models, because it really made us feel like we were a part of something. Because I feel like that's one thing that sets someone off, is when you're in the classroom, you're kind of just confined to you and the girls in your classroom. And then you don't really get to communicate with any of the girls on the floor, which there's a lot of girls on the floor and not a lot of girls in the classroom. So for them to come in and ask us if we wanted to be models was very sweet of them. And since then, I've met a ton of girls on the floor. I'm friends with a few of them, so that was really nice. So if you do go and there are any shows, try your best to get yourself in and make as many friends, talk to as many girls as you can. And as far as trips goes, there's actually a trip in a few days for New York. So they're having like a Toni&Guy New York show thing. If you also are going and there are ever trips, try your best to go. And yeah, that's basically everything I really wanted to touch base upon. The first month of school was amazing. I don't regret going at all. I love every second of school. I go in every single day excited to learn something new. And if I have any advice for you, if you are interested in going or you're not sure or you're already signed up and starting, a few tips I have are to just stay organized, because you get a lot of paperwork and you get a lot of head sheets. You get a lot of different papers, so make sure you're organized with those. Stay true to yourself. Be who you are. There are a ton of girls there, okay? And I know that can be intimidating sometimes, but just be you. Don't try to force being someone else to impress the other girls, because it's not gonna happen. Just be you and just have fun. It's such a fun experience. You're going to absolutely love it if you wanna do it. And I really hope this video was helpful for you, or if you just are a subscriber and just felt like watching this, I hope you enjoyed it. But if any of you do have any other questions, you are very welcome to ask me questions down in the comments, and I will definitely answer any of them. But don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up, and also again, don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye guys.